Καλώς ήρθατε.
Ladies and gentlemen, I very much appreciate the opportunity to speak before such a distinguished audience at this year's Concordia Summit. In my capacity as Prime Minister of Greece, I am particularly glad and proud that successful and esteemed members of the Board of Directors of Concordia are of Greek descent. The perspective of collaboration in facing domestic and global challenges, which is Concordia's strategic input, is as vital as never before. And it is particularly useful to the European Union, which, although itself the historical product of political collaboration, has shifted the burden of solution of transnational crises onto national governments. And that, at a time that Europe has become the crossroads of three parallel global crises, the migration crisis, the security crisis spanning from Northern Africa to the Middle East, and the economic crisis. It was, in fact, the management of the 2008 financial and economic crisis that marked to shift to the logic of nationalizing collective problems. The recourse to the logic, not in my own backyard, avoiding necessary reforms to deepen integration in the social, economic, and fiscal domains, is the reason that Europe has not yet recovered from that crisis. To put it differently, Europe, pursuing a dogmatic austerity agenda on the initiative of the creditor countries of Northern Europe, has failed in what the United States, under a democratic administration, succeeded to halt the crisis. The same logic characterizes the management of the refugee crisis. Many European Union member states have, in practice, denied relocation of refugees from the countries of first entry, mainly from Greece. However, in a wider environment of uncertainty, indecisiveness, and turmoil, Greece remained an anchor of geopolitical stability. And this is an indispensable condition for European stability. Greece's geostrategic value is indisputable for five reasons. First, we play a stabilizing role in the Western Balkans. Second, we serve a central role for Europe as a frontline country in the management of migration and refugee flows, located at the EU's most sensitive external border. Third, we are becoming a crucial energy, transport and trade hub in a period where new routes of natural gas as well as railway and maritime interconnections in the region are being developed. Fourth, we pursue a multidimensional active foreign policy promoting stability and cooperation in our region and beyond the region. We're enhancing relations with traditional allies and friends while developing relations with emerging economies. And fifth, we are a pillar of stability and a credible interlocutor in the Eastern Mediterranean and the broader region, where the security situation, as everybody see, is increasingly deteriorating. This is because we have developed relations with countries of the region on a bilateral, trilateral together with Cyprus, and multilateral level. Ladies and gentlemen, last year Greece made bold and decisive steps to secure its internal political and economic stability. This year marks the turn of the economy from recession to economic recovery. Brexit is now history. Growth is now in sight. The Greek economy overperformed in 2015. We have been undertaking all the necessary growth-oriented reforms. We have created an investment-friendly institutional environment with stable corporate tax rates for 12 years for investments over 40 million euros. We have legislated a meritocratic and efficient public sector, breaking away from the past practices of clientelism and bureaucratic apathy. We are fighting every single day against corruption and against the oligarchic interests, which are connected with the old political system and prevented transparency and competition. However, for our country to enter the path of sustainable growth, our creditors should do their part in restoring the sustainability of our public debt. According to the agreement, that we signed last summer, the time to do so is now, today, not tomorrow. By the end of this year, the concrete measures of debt relief should be specified and announced so that a clear, very clear signal is sent to investors and the markets that Greece is back, that the years of the crisis are over. By the end of 2016, the horizon should be cleared. Not after, but before the election year 2017 for major European countries. From my view, this is the indispensable condition for Greece to participate in the QE program of the European Central Bank and to return to the markets in 2017. And this is the responsibility of all international creditors. Debt easing will be the final curtain to a modern Greek tragedy. For that reason, no one has the right to hesitate or procrastinate. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for your attention. I'm very happy to be here with you in these crucial times for Greece, for Europe, and I believe strongly that you will continue to support our efforts to recover. Thank you very much.